Hello, my name is Paula Jasmine, and this video blog I want to dedicate it to a very good friend of mine that is going through some difficulties at this time. If you're watching this, I want you to know that you have my support, and I want you to know that I hope that things get better, and hopefully I will see you soon. Anyway, today I want to talk about religion. I'm an atheist. I don't believe in God, and I certainly don't support any type of organized religion. However, I grew up in a Catholic family, and I also went to a Catholic school, and I also went to a and I graduated from a Christian school. Besides the fact that in Puerto Rico, religion plays a very important role in our society. So certainly I think I can have a strong opinion about the impact that religion has had in my life as a transgender woman. And when you are transgender, doesn't matter whether you are a male to female or a female to male, at some point, one point or another, you are going to have to deal with your religious background, especially because not many religions are quite open to accepting transgender people. Neither they are quite open to accept gay, lesbian, transgender people. Certainly in Puerto Rico, because my culture is not very accepting of gay, lesbian, transgender people, their religion also is not very accepting of gay, lesbian, transgender people. And actually, it might be the opposite, because since when Puerto Rico was discovered by Christopher Columbus, Spanish people came to live in the island, and they bring their religion. And in Spain, at that time, the main religion was Catholic religion, and as such, they bring their religious belief to our culture. So basically, our culture is based on Catholic, on the Catholic influence. So basically, because the Catholic Church in Puerto Rico is very conservative, the same thing will happen to the culture. The culture is also very conservative, and it's not very open to transgender people, which means that because I was born down there, I had a lot of issues to deal with, because I had to deal with that big wall that was made by culture and religion tied up together. And for me to be able to transition, I had to find a way to get that wall broken before I transition. Certainly, as I think almost everybody that have talked about religion and being transgender, they mentioned Deuteronomy 22:5, and I, at the same time, in my culture, I hear that same passage being mentioned when people, priests, preachers, and even my family were expressing their opinion about transgender people. And that passage, in case you are curious about what it says, basically it says that a woman shall not be wearing man's clothes, and that a man should be wearing woman's clothes, because that's an abomination in the eyes of God. As I said, being transgender meant that I had to deal with the feelings associated from hearing that perspective and people believing that to be true. And certainly it was hard for me, because since I knew that I was transgender at an early age, I knew that I had to deal with a lot of guilty feelings towards for most of my life, until I finally was able to say to myself, okay, enough of this. What do I believe myself? Forget about what the priest says in church. Forget about what your parents says. Forget about what society says. What do I believe? So that's the question that I start asking myself, and I start finding my own answer deep inside. And honestly, it was very difficult because you are concerned, you are asking yourself, like, okay, they are saying that this is wrong, but certainly, you know, by me being this way and me experiencing this on my own, I'm beginning to question that, are they wrong or am I wrong? And little by little, I began moving to the direction of, like, I'm okay. They are the ones that are wrong. And that's what I now believe. You know, I believe that being transgender or being gay or lesbian or bisexual, there's nothing wrong with that. It's basically who you are. It's not like you have a choice of not being this way or that way. No. This is who you are, what your personality is. It's not a choice that you make, you know. It's not like you choose to eat meat or eggs, you know. It's not a choice. You don't choose to be this way. You are born this way. This is who you are. This is the way that your personality is. And when religious people say that this is a choice, they don't know what they're talking about. This is not a choice. This is who we are as human beings. You know, everybody's different. You know, not everybody can be the same. And I think if everybody would be the same in this war, I think it would be a very boring war, because certainly there wouldn't be the diversity that exists. And what I like about life is the diversity that exists in the world. And certainly being transgender adds more to that diversity that exists in the world. And I'm quite proud of being transgender. I'm quite proud of everything that I have been able to go over to get to this point. And certainly, I want to, if you are a transgender person and you are in those initial stages, and you're questioning who is right and who is wrong, I want you to realize that you are okay. There's nothing wrong with you. You are a human being. You're okay. There's nothing wrong with being transgender. You are not going to go to hell. You are not a sinner. You are not a bad person. You are not going to die. God is not going to kill you. It's all based on perspective. And the fact that really sometimes religion has a different perspective doesn't mean that that's true. Most of the fact comes because they don't understand and there's fear to the unknown. And as someone that has to deal with that to be able to move forward, I think that once you accept yourself and as you realize there's nothing wrong with who you are, then you can move forward and find the happiness that everybody needs, is looking for, you know. And it's a long process. It will take time. It's not going to be easy. For me, it wasn't easy. I even have issues with my mom, because my mom was very religious, and my mom even told me that I shouldn't transition because I was going to commit a crime against my soul. So yeah, there's a lot of fear associated with being trans, and there's a lot of misunderstanding. And religion doesn't understand us very well. But, in my opinion, there's nothing wrong with being trans. And to the preachers and priests and religious leaders that use the Bible to condemn or discriminate against transgender people, or use the whole religion to cause fear and try to cause promote this hate in society using religion. That's what I tell you. That's my message to you guys. And this is from somebody that you know very well, or that you think you know very well. This is from Jesus. And in Matthew 7:1-2, Jesus said, and I'm going to quote directly from that because I don't want to mess up. Jesus said in Matthew 7:1-2, "Judge not that you be not judged. For what judgment you judge, you shall be judged." Basically, Jesus is telling you that we shouldn't judge somebody else. Because if we judge somebody, we're going to be judged. He's going to judge you with the same measure. So, me, I'm an atheist. I could care less about this. But you people, that believe in God or consider yourself Christians and believe in the teachings of Jesus Christ, you should know this. And it really surprised me when I hear it in the news, or when I hear Christian people, or so-called Christian people, judging us and telling us how we should live our lives. Who are you to judge us? No answer. Who are you to judge us? Ask yourself that. Jesus Christ said that you shall not judge others, and you're judging us? What kind of Christian are you, you know? So, next time, think about that. And before you decide to make a comment, a negative comment, or promote hatred, or promote violence, or discriminate transgender people, think about that. And remember what Jesus said. Judge not that you be not judged. This is it. Have a good day. And I'll see you next time. Peace.